guys. Trying a different audio today. How art thou? Another cooking video. Yay! You have no idea the hassle I have gone to make this video. So definitely watch it. Right, somebody challenged me, I think it was in the last video, to have a go with the Ridgemonkey and make an apple pie. So I thought, you're on. I can't remember who it was, so sorry about that. But that's what I'm going to do in this one. We're going to have a go, because I don't have an oven, you see. There's no oven in here. So, I better switch my gas on, hadn't I? Because we ain't going to get very far, are we, if we've got nothing to cook on. Right, the ingredients are... I've got some pre-made pastry. I guess you mostly make your own. But as I didn't want to make quite so much mess in here, I decided to buy a pre-rolled one. Yes, I'll let you know in advance that you can buy a apple pie in the co-op for £1.30. And most of my ingredients came to more than double that. So, is it worth it? No, it isn't. But it's just the fact that you can do it if you so wished. Well, I'm assuming I can. This is a completely new tryout, so we might end up with total and utter burnt offerings. I've no idea as to whether this is going to work or not. But it's worth making a video for, so let's jump in. Right, so we've got our... we've got our pre-made pastry there. I've got some mixed ground spice as well there to make it taste a little bit better. I've got a few raisins as well to go in it. And obviously the apples. Right, let's get these out first. Right, I've no idea how many apples I'm going to use, probably two. So let's get a plate. I'm actually on my drive. I wanted to do this video a while ago, but because the GoPro wouldn't link to my phone app, and it took me about 3 or 4 hours to actually reset it and get it all working, I never actually got to do the video because it was too damn dark. So this is the second or third attempt I've tried at this one now, so hopefully it'll work a bit better. Right, I'm going to peel the apples. I'm not actually going to stew them. I'm going to cut them up into chunks and put them in the pastry straight away with a few herbs. So we'll see how we get on with that. Shall I use that one? Let's get a plate. There we go. Right. So peel your apple first. It's really need one of those electric drills, isn't it? Do you remember the electric drill trick? That was potatoes, I think, wasn't it? You stick your fork in the electric drill and turn it with your peeler. Which I thought, yeah, that's quite clever. I've just peeled that. And it's going brown already. That's a bit weird, isn't it? Shouldn't go brown that quick. But there we know. Well, they've got radiated in them or something, have they? Blimey. Anyway, whatever. Right, let's cut up some chunks. I would imagine probably mostly, most definitely, the smaller the better, I would imagine. Would imagine mostly, probably. we'll just cut them up into little strips in a minute. Just get the core off them. My God, these are going brown. Cool. Not bin down there. Right, let's cut those into smaller bits. Smaller pieces. Chopping my finger off, because we wouldn't want a red apple pie, would we? Yes, I've no idea how this is going to turn out. Absolutely no idea. Yes, if you were, I think if Janie did it, hedgecombers, if you want to see Janie do an apple crumble, I believe it was, with the, what was it, hobnobs as the crunchy stuff, or the crumble a bit, then go and have a look on her channel, because that was really nice. I believe Nick Rick made one as well on one of our camps when we were away. Right, actually I don't think you guys can see. Wait a minute, let's turn you around a minute. How's that? Can you see that? Right, so we've got our Ridgemonkey. Just put that over there a minute. Right, now we want our pastry. So if we open this one up, how does the box open? It just comes out the end, does it? I suppose. You can see I've done this before, can't you? So how much have we got in here then? Right. Right, let's open our pastries. It looks a bit thin. Oh, it does look thin. Oh no, I see it. It's got a pastry paper on it. Yeah, okay, whatever. Right, let's open up our pastry. Oh, I don't want to put nothing. Right, let's roll it out, our pastryus. And what we need is our a square big enough to fit in our Ridgemonkey. So I'll take our Ridgemonkey and go, yeah, about that big, like that, and like that. Right, rough idea. And we want two pieces like this, because obviously we want one for our top, and one for the bottom. So how about that then? Right, there's our first bit of pastry. I'm hoping this is going to fit in here without it all sticking. That's a little bit big, actually. That's a bit big, Ost. So we'll have to chop that bit off there. We'll roll that down in a minute. Right, let's put that one in there. Hopefully this isn't, actually, I know what I'll do. Wait a minute. I'll need to put some non-sticky stuff in there as well. I did have some spray, but now I don't have any, so we'll have to, we can't use that. So we'll have to go with this method. I'm going to put a bit of light oil on here, I think. I imagine you could probably glaze this as well. You can probably glaze your pastry with some, with an egg or some milk, if you've got a brush in your van. Right, that's almost done. Let's put a bit more on there a minute. Right, that's that one greased. Let's turn that over, and then we'll grease this side. If you guys can see what I'm doing, I've basically put a bit of oil on the tissue, on the kitchen roll, and just wiping it in the Ridgemonkey. Right, let's put that away. Right, now we got our pastry. We'll just stick that in there. Right, and then we'll roll out another one of the same size. Actually, no, we won't, because we haven't got enough. We'll have to roll out a smaller one. Because I don't have a rolling pin. But never mind. Right. Let's, actually, you could do this in a bowl, actually, because we know how big it is, don't we? Put that there a minute. Hopefully you guys can still see there. Right, let's get my thing is I don't have flour or anything like that. Let's put this back. Right, we've got our pie here, or our piece of pastry. Can you guys see that? Can you see all right? Should be able to see. Yeah. Right, put some Bits of apple in there. In the middle. Like so. These aren't cooking apples, these are eating apples. I wanted something a little bit sweeter. I probably will put some sugar on these as well. Probably, definitely will, possibly. I've no idea how this is going to work. I've absolutely no idea, but we'll give it a go. I've got some custard down there too. Well, there's a few bits left, but I'll put those to one side. Right, let's see if I can find a bit of sugar. Right, let's sprinkle a bit of sugar over the top of these. Maybe a bit too much, but never mind. Right. I don't even know how long this is going to take to cook. No idea. Right, now we're going to take a few raisins, a few currants. Put them in there as well. Whoops. A few currantsies. Raisins in there. That'd be nice. Put that in there. Not too many. Right, that's that one. Right, we want our spice. Sprinkle a little bit of this over the top as well. Da, da, da. If it come out, go on, come out in a big, huge lump. Mess it all up. So it makes it completely unedible. I suppose what I should do is put it in my hand, shouldn't I? There we are. I'll put it in my hand and then sprinkle it over like that. Yeah, that's better. That's using your sense. So I'm still coming off my tablet, so I'm probably sounding completely incoherent, so I do apologise. Right, let's put that over there. There you go. There's a bit of spice in there as well. Right, now we're going to get our other piece. Stick that on the top, like so. And just press it down a little bit. Can you guys see all right? Hopefully you can. Oh, that smells really nice. Right, let's press it down like that. Hopefully, can you guys see? I think you can see what I'm doing. What I thought I might do is sort of crimp the edges a little bit, bend them over like that. Let's move that out of the way a minute. Just move that out of the way. Put that over there. Stick that down there. Right, just like you would if it was like a pastry, like a pasty or something. Can you see that all right? You guys see that? Just sort of crumple it up around the edge. Because I thought I might try and seal all the juices in, you see. Or at least that's the idea. I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm making a mess, I know that much. I've no idea if any of this is going to work. Oh, you know, I can see it now. It's just going to turn out to be a flipping disaster. You watch. Absolute disaster. Don't think this is going to work, but never mind. Right, let's bunch these corners in because they're a tiny bit of pastry, isn't it? There's a hole there. Right. Whatever asked, whatever. Right. Apparently, now that is an apple pie, right? Apparently. Right, if I can unstick it. Right, now we'll stick it into our Ridgemonkey like so. Right, I'm going to just wrap that back up again and I'll take that back indoors and do something with that in a minute. Maybe make a little apple pie, maybe, I don't know. Anyway, right, can you guys see? Probably not. Let's move you around a bit. There we are. Right, there we go. Can you see the apple pie there, look? It's not the most attractive thing in the world, Actually, it's pretty damn ugly. Have I run out of gas? I do hope not. Right. Let's put that down on low. And I'm just praying to God it doesn't stick. And now we're going to heat it gently. We're going to have to turn it over quite a few times as well. Let's see how long it says to cook. Preheat an oven, not possible. Oh no, that's defrosting, sorry. Fancies are marked for a temperature required in your recipe. Well, I don't have one, so. If we just go on, 20 minutes? No idea, but we'll give it a go. Right, let's cook. This is where the audio goes, so I'll probably run out of audio because the battery goes flat. No, it's still working. For now. Cool. Oh, yeah, scumbag, it's sticking already. No, it's sticking already. Well, it does say 200 degrees, and I'm not even putting 200 in it. Ideally, I think the way to do this to get the best results is going to be to put it in a Dutch oven, or a make some smaller pies that you can put in the Dutch oven on a trivet. I was going to try and use my casserole dish instead of my Dutch oven, but I don't have a trivet for it. I don't know if any of you guys ever saw one of my earlier videos. I'll put in the link up here. No, here. Here. There. Somewhere. Where it was how to make scones. Was it scones? Cookies? I can't remember. Making something in a toolbox. I actually cooked something in the toolbox, and I'll tell you what, it was quite nice. So that was a really interesting video to go and watch if you haven't seen that one. Oh, this is starting to smell nice. Ooh, ooh, that's doing something. Oh God. Well, that's looking quite nice already, isn't it? It's not sticking, so that's good. Right, let's keep that warm then. The thing is, this is not the thing to cook it in. You do not cook it in a Ridgemonkey. See, it's still starting to burn a little bit. The problem with cooking it like this, you see, is it needs to be off the ground, as it were. It doesn't need to be in contact with the pan. It should be on a trivet inside, which I don't have, you see. Now, I can't do that with the Ridgemonkey. So, I suppose it is more of an apple turnover type pancake thing, really, because of the way I'm cooking it. It's supposed to cook like pastry, but it's not really going to do that. That's got a big hole in it. Can you see that big hole? There's a big hole there.
There's a big hole in the side. Never mind. Keep going, Ross. Keep going. Keep going. Oh, I didn't set a timer. I just realised I haven't put my clock right either. It's not the right time.
Minutes so far. Wow, we ain't cut nothing yet. All we got is a Ridgemonkey with some burnt offerings in it. So sorry about that. Mm. can't tell. Yes, I've got my custard to go with it. Yeah, definitely got my custard. You can't make apple pies without custard, can you? Definitely not. So much sizzling there, I don't like the sound of that. I think that's probably the apple. Probably coming out. Let's have a look. Oh, no, okay. It definitely, yeah, it doesn't really look like a pie. It definitely doesn't look like a pie. No. Well, my cooker's down as low as it will go. I can't go down any lower. I think what you've got to do is not not to have any expectations. Don't have any expectations. Just think to yourself, it's some pastry and apple. Don't have an idea of what an apple pie actually is supposed to look like, because this isn't one of them. Well, actually, this is one of them. This is one of those that isn't supposed to look like a traditional apple pie, all right? I'll just warn you now. Actually, it smells quite nice. It does smell quite nice. And it is cooking. And I did say 20 minutes, and I think that's just over 5 so far. I think. Not quite sure. Yes, I've got a different camera up here. If it's working, or if it works, then you'll get some extra footage, which I don't normally do. But I've got the Hero 3 up here and the Hero 4 down there. And it is a little bit dark in here, so I do apologise. It is a bit of a rainy day today, and it's dark outside. It's not very bright. And I was rather stupid, because I should have actually put some lights on in here. Because it was lighter when I started the video. But that's me all over, innit? Right, let's go for another flipsies. Let's see what that's like then, shall we? Oh yes, that's looking very nice. Yep. Looking quite pastry-like. Quite pastry-like. What are we on now? It's about 7 or 8 minutes, something like that. So, about 15 minutes probably still. So we've got a while to wait yet. Key the time lapse. Nearly 20 minutes now. Let's give you a look. That's what we've got now. Let me turn it over and you can have a look at the other side. And that's that side. Like I say, it is a little bit brown, but I still wouldn't call that quite burnt. But as you can see, it's held up quite well. The pastry seems to have cooked okay round here. I think that's going to be okay. I think that'll look all right. I think that's nearly done. What I need to do now, if I turn that right down, I'll move my kettle out of the way. Right, let's get rid of that. Let's get a plate. And let's see what we've made. Right. Look at that. That's massive. That's a massive apple pie. And there you go. Do you know what? That smells nice. Should we have a look, see what it's like inside? Let's cut it open. Oh, the pastry's okay. Yeah, oh, there, that's nice. Pastry's cut nicely, actually. So about, I would say about 20 minutes then. Oh yeah, that is nice. The apple's still a little bit solid. Actually, no, it's softened up a little bit. And there you go. There you go, if you can see that. I'm looking forward to trying it. Let's try a little bit. Go on, let's try a little bit. I think it might be a bit hot. Pastry. The pastry's really nice. Let me get a spoon a minute. I'm pretty frightened to try it. Let's try a bit here, look. Right, so I've got a little bit of apple, a little bit of pastry. Right, let's see what's like. Doesn't smell very cinnamony. That's not bad, actually. Oh, not bad. Considering I didn't have an oven. Tiny bit bland, but if you want to make an apple pie in a Ridgemonkey, it is possible. So there you go. Right. I'm going to go indoors and finish the rest of this because it's quite nice. Right. There you go. There's proof that you can make apple pie in a Ridgemonkey. So, yeah. Actually, that does smell nice. Right. Love and light, guys. Have a great rest of the day. And go and have a go yourself. Get some pastry. Some short crust pastry. And go and have a go yourself. Because, yeah, it's a bit of fun. Anyway, love and light, guys. Have a great rest of the day. Enjoy your apple thing. And see you next vid. Thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe and click the bell icon. If you want regular updates, head over to my website. Over there you'll see stay updated on every video. Put your email address in there and submit, and you'll get a regular update to every video I upload. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you have a great rest of the day. Please like and subscribe and share the video, and I will see you in the next video.